नमस्ते, वेलकम टू कैवल्य योगा गुरुकुलम केवाईजी। लेट्स बिगिन द क्लास विद वन ओम एंड देन ऑफर आवर सैल्यूटेशंस टू द डिवाइन सद्गुरु एंड इनवोक द पावर ऑफ गणेश फ्रॉम द मूलाधार। ओम लेट्स ऑफर आवर सैल्यूटेशंस सद्गुरु। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम। लेट अस इनवोक द डिवाइन एनर्जी ऑफ गणेश फ्रॉम आवर मूलाधार, सो द लर्निंग, अंडरस्टैंडिंग, एबिलिटी टू चैंट बिकम्स इजी। ओम गंगणपतये नमः। Let us revise what we have learned so far. We will chant each of these verses twice and then begin to learn the new verse. Let's chant it together. Each line twice.
Nidhanapataye namaha. निधनपतये नमः। निधनपतान्तिकाय नमः। निधनपतान्तिकाय नमः। ऊर्ध्वाय नमः। ऊर्ध्वाय नमः। ऊर्ध्वलिंगाय नमः। ऊर्ध्वलिंगाय नमः। हिरण्याय नमः। हिरण्याय नमः। हिरण्यलिंगाय नमः। हिरण्यलिंगाय नमः। सुवर्णाय नमः। सुवर्णाय नमः। सुवर्णलिंगाय नमः। सुवर्णलिंगाय नमः। दिव्याय नमः। दिव्याय नमः। दिव्यलिंगाय नमः। दिव्यलिंगाय नमः। भवाय नमः। भवाय नमः। भवलिंगाय नमः। भवलिंगाय नमः। शर्वाय नमः। शर्वाय नमः। शर्वलिंगाय नमः। शर्वलिंगाय नमः। शिवाय नमः। शिवाय नमः। शिवलिंगाय नमः। शिवलिंगाय नमः। ज्वलाय नमः। ज्वलाय नमः। ज्वललिंगाय नमः। ज्वललिंगाय नमः। आत्माय नमः। आत्माय नमः। आत्मलिंगाय नमः। आत्मलिंगाय नमः। परमाय नमः। परमाय नमः, परमलिंगाय नमः, परमलिंगाय नमः। एतत् सोमस्य सूर्यस्य सर्वलिंगगस्थापयति पाणिमन्त्रं पवित्रम्। एतत् सोमस्य सूर्यस्य सर्वलिंगगस्थापयति पाणिमन्त्रं पवित्रम्। सद्यो जातं प्रपद्यामि सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः। सद्यो जातं प्रपद्यामि सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः। भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्व माम्। भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्व माम्। भवोद्भवाय नमः, भवोद्भवाय नमः। वामदेवाय नमो, वामदेवाय नमो। ज्येष्ठाय नमः, श्रेष्ठाय नमो। ज्येष्ठाय नमः, श्रेष्ठाय नमो। अगेन, ज्येष्ठाय नमः, श्रेष्ठाय नमो।
We will chant these three lines together and repeat it because of the kh that comes after namaha.
Rudraya namah, Kalaya namah, Kalavikaranaya namo. Rudraya namah, Kalaya namah, Kalavikaranaya namo.
Wonderful.
Balavikaranaya namo, Balavikaranaya namo, Balaya namo, Balaya namo, Balavikaranaya Balapramathanaya namas.
So this Balapramathanaya and the next line, we'll join it together. Let's chant it together.
Balapramathanaya namas, Sarvabhutadamanaya namo. Balapramathanaya namas, Sarvabhutadamanaya namo. Manonmanaya namaha, Manonmanaya namaha.
Wonderful, wonderful. So we learnt about the west facing Shiva, Sadhyojata, who represented the newborn consciousness, newly born consciousness. And then we meditated upon the Vamadeva aspect, the Shakti aspect of Shiva, the left side facing north in the previous verses. And now we come to the right side, the powerful side of Shiva. Why do we say right is more powerful, more masculine and so on? Because most of us, there are exceptions of course, but most of us use right hand for everything, for all actions, for grasping, writing. To show strength, immediately we pick up our right hand and show the strength. So right hand is very active than the left hand for most of us, right? So it is just taken from that. Don't read too much into this. This is not about sexism and so on. But this is simply about the right side being more active and therefore more extrovert, more ready to go out, reach out, grab stuff and so on. So right hand is more active. So the right side facing south is Aghora. Facing south is Aghora. So in yoga, when you from up, this is ascension of consciousness. So when you look down, then you're looking at descent of consciousness, where consciousness gets trapped in the Mooladhara, in the fear and instinct, survival instinct and so on. This tendency to get trapped in the Mooladhara, in the region of the senses, earth and water element begin to trap us, right? We create a reality around us, such as what you and I experience for most part, every day. And therefore, the south side, it is said, is like facing death on this side. Because the true birth is what? Birth into spirituality. When you're truly reborn, that is why baptism in Christianity or initiation in Vedanta, in all religions, there is a form of initiation or baptism and so on and so forth, right? The idea here is you are reborn into the spiritual world. So here, the real birth in Vedanta, the real birth in yoga, the real birth in spirituality is when you begin to live the life as an ocean, not as a river. The river is just flowing. When it merges into the ocean, when Sadyojata happens, then true spirituality begins. So until then, what happens? The southern side, that means the lower side. So the west side of the body is back. The left side is here. The right side is here, north, south, west, east. So north and south can also be understood as up and down. So when you're facing downwards, it is aghora. You need that terrifying aspect of Shiva to look down upon that part and say, enough is enough, wake up. That is where we are coming today. And so today we are just going to learn this verse, but it's a very powerful verse. I want you to learn this with reverence and meditate upon this in this verse. Aghora, we're going to come across this term, aghora. Just as Vamadeva and all the beautiful aspect of Shiva, we are also seeing the other aspect of Shiva. And it is important for us to embrace this aspect of Shiva. We cannot only run away from anything that scares us or terrifies us. We cannot afford to do that. Why? Because the mind has to rise above that, about this idea of duality, right and wrong, bad and good, and black and white, and what is terrifying and what is not terrifying. All of that has to cease. Everything is Shiva consciousness. That is what we are training in this meditation, in understanding the five faces of Shiva, right? You can't say, I don't want this aspect of Shiva, I only want that aspect of Shiva. You and I can't make the choice. We get Shiva in his entirety when he presents himself to us, right? When you get a car, you get the car along with all the pros and cons of driving at 60 miles per hour or 70 miles per hour on the highway. It's fun, but it's also potential for any danger, right? So the whole thing comes in a package. Shiva comes to us in a package. Let us understand, accept, and then see how this beautiful aspect of Shiva actually helps us. Aghora, aghora, not so terrifying. Now, when I had a Saint Bernard, and he was a very big dog, 250 pounds or so, children would come. And then what would I say to encourage the child towards the dog? Say, don't worry, he's not so bad. He's not going to harm you. Come, 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 right? So on the one side, there is a positive side. But then you also have to say, don't worry, he's not going to harm you. He's not so terrifying. You can come closer. So that is the approach here. Aghora is, wait a minute, this aspect of Shiva, this aspect where I'm going to get lost, Sundar is going to lose himself in Shiva and all of that, that fear could hold us back. And it does in many ways. It disguises itself in the form of, I don't have time for this, or we don't need to chant all this, just bhakti is enough. All these are disguises of fear, trying to prevent us from facing Shiva in all his mighty. But if you love him, if you accept this powerful consciousness and you want that consciousness, experience it, then you have to embrace it with all fearlessness. Aghora, not so terrifying. Aghora. Ghora means terrifying. Aghora is not so terrifying. So here, you're first starting with aghorebhyo. I am saluting this not so terrifying feature of Shiva. Facing south, he's facing death. And because he's facing death and keeping death, what is death? whenever we are caught up in body consciousness, sensual consciousness, and living this robotic life of what to eat, what to sleep, and what to see, and what to hear, then we are as good as dead, because it's robotic. Life is robotic, right? So he looks at that life with fierceness. But he is not so terrifying. And at the same time, he is aghora and then ghorebhyo. Ghora, ghora tarebhyo. Ghora means terrifying. Ghora tara, very terrifying, extremely terrifying. There is no other way to sugarcoat these words. Whenever there is situation, why is this mantra so powerful? Because this aspect of Shiva is very beneficial, very benevolent, though it seems like this. A doctor's, surgeon's knife seems very dangerous. That's why they put you in coma, right? Not coma, I mean, what do you call it? They put you in anesthesia, because you will see the knife coming and slicing open a part of your body. You're not going to like it. It's terrifying. So if you're in anesthesia, you don't feel that. And the doctor's actual action saves you. That is what we have to understand here. Whenever there is a situation in our lives, and many of us get caught in such situations which are very unpleasant, very stressful, instead of blaming X or Y, my co-workers are causing this, my boss is causing this, or my spouse is causing this discomfort for me, or this one or that one, let us implore this aspect of Shiva and say, you remove the circumstance from me, not the persons. You and I cannot judge who is causing and who is not. We could be completely wrong in our judgment. But the fact that we are in this discomfortable, uncomfortable position and not liking it, how do I get out of this circumstance? Why am I caught in this negative thinking? Why am I caught in this depression? Is what we need to ask ourselves and say. Then we implore Shiva and say, aghorebhyo, ghora ghora tarebhyo, you come with your terrifying and destroy this circumstance from me, remove this negativity from me. That is the power that we are invoking. This Shiva therefore will come and remove those negative impulses that hold us back, that cause depression or sadness or littleness and so on and so forth. So it's a very powerful mantra by itself. Each of these verses is a mantra by itself. Okay, that's why we are taking verses only to study every day. So, how is this chanted?
Aghore bhyotha, bhyotha.
Emphasis on both bhyo and tha. So, you see the green now. So, you know there are two notes to go.
Aghore bhyotha, ghore bhyo.
Gho, it is also not G-O but G-H-O, right? Gho. So gho and bhyo and tha, there is a lot of aspirations and the ha comes along. So a lot of mahaprana is there in this. There's a lot of energy in this mantra. That's why they have used these Sanskrit letters. So a lot of energy comes into our deep into our unconscious mind when we chant these mantras. And that energy is what removes all negativity around us and recreates a circumstance. And one day we'll say, wow, everything just disappeared. Magically almost. That is the power of the Shiva mantra. Please listen.
Aghore bhyotha.
Let us focus on gho, bhya and tha. Right?
Aghore bhyotha.
Let's chant it together.
Aghore bhyotha, aghore bhyotha.
Again.
Aghore bhyotha.
Again.
Aghore bhyotha.
Wonderful. Next. Listen.
Ghore bhyo, ghore bhyo. Ghore bhyo.
Let us chant it together.
Ghore bhyo.
Again.
Ghore bhyo.
Again.
Ghore bhyo.
Wonderful. Let's join the first and the second line together. Please listen once.
Aghore bhyotha, ghore bhyo.
Listen to it one more time.
अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो.
लेट्स चैंट इट टुगेदर.
अघोरेभ्यो,
आई एम सॉरी, लेट्स डू इट अगेन.
अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो.
अगेन.
अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो.
वन मोर टाइम.
अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो.
So when you're learning this and trying on your own, first learn the notations, then you focus on the pronunciation. Take one step at a time, right? The next, the third word is
ghora ghora tarebhyaha.
Ghora ghora, ghora ghora tarebhyaha. So it's beautiful here.
Ghora 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 tarebhyaha.
Let's chant it together.
घोर घोर तरेभ्यः, घोर घोर तरेभ्यः.
See, elderly people, older people who feel they are losing memory and all of this, this is that energy that will destroy all of that. Remove that darkness, the sloth, the inability to perceive and comprehend, all that will go. Clarity will come, life will come because of the mantras that follow this. So don't be afraid of this mantra. It's a very beautiful, powerful mantra. We need all to remove all things that limit us, that create a negative pattern. So listen to this line once and we'll chant it twice together. It might be difficult, but be patient.
Aghorebhyoth ghorebhyo, ghora ghora tarebhyaha.
Let's chant it together.
Aghorebhyoth ghorebhyo, ghora ghora tarebhyaha.
Again.
Aghorebhyoth ghorebhyo, ghora ghora tarebhyaha.
Again.
Aghorebhyoth ghorebhyo, घोर घोर तरेभ्यः.
वेरी गुड. देन आफ्टर दिस
सर्वेभ्यस्,
फर्स्ट लिसन टू द होल लाइन, देन वी विल ब्रेक इट अपार्ट.
सर्वेभ्यः सर्व सर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्र रूपेभ्यः.
सर्वेभ्य Sarva Sarva come. Sarvebhyas Sarva. Sarva is what? All. What do you do with this all? Sarvebhyo. Sarva. Remember the Sarva. Everything is dissolved. All that negativity that we called upon this Aghora to look upon, take your Aghora aspect and destroy that negativity. Remove it from my life. We are co-creating with the divine here. We are not asking, pleading, playing a victim mindset. There is no I and me and mine here. It is just allow this to happen. We are co-creating with the divine. It is almost like willing with the divine backing this mantra. The energy of the mantra will remove that negativity in your life. And it will continue to purify that till this I itself dissolves, becomes Shiva. So Sarva, 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 Rudra. Who does this? Rudra. Rudra, the same Rudra from Vamadeva aspect. Here is also, invoke Rudra here also. The same with the right brilliant rays of the sun. Come and remove all this negativity. Destroy that with your Aghora. Rudra, rays of the sun. Rupa is formed. Rudra Rupebhyaha. Okay?
Sarvebhyas Sarva.
Sar is first a sa. Okay?
Sarve,
because of the green, remember? So,
Sarvebhyas Sarva. Sarvebhyas Sarva.
Let's chant it together twice.
Sarvebhyas Sarva. Sarvebhyas Sarva.
That Bhyas Sarva. Remember that we learned it in the previous verses also. Bhyas and S comes there. So double S, if you will. So the Bhyas, it joins together. Sarve Bhyas Sarva. It's almost like one word. Okay. Again, let's chant it twice. Sarve Bhyas Sarva. One more time. Sarve Bhyas Sarva. Excellent. The next one is Sha. So Sa and Sha, it's a play of words, it's poetry, it's power, everything brought together. There's nothing like Vedic chants, nothing really, nothing comparable to the energy that is here. Sa and Sha. Sarve Bhyas Sarva, Sharve Bhyo, Sharve Bhyo, Sharve Bhyo. The next word was Sharve Bhyo. Sh as in shirt. S with a small stroke above it is Sh. So let's chant it together. Twice. Sharve Bhyo. Again. Sharve Bhyo. Wonderful. Let's join that together. How is that joined? Please listen. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. All these are forming neurons in your brain. That's why it's difficult. The whole system might resist it. Your tongue will seem like it's frozen when you chant these complicated verses. But allow this to happen. Let the neurons be formed in the brain. That's how these are the mantras that help the gray matter in the brain to actually physically expand, grow. There's no aging as far as the brain is concerned. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Let's chant it together. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Two more times. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Again. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. First say that 3-4 times. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Then you begin to pull the tune. The next one is Namaste Astu. Namaste Astu. Simple. Namaste Astu. Let's chant it together. Twice. Namaste Astu. Namaste Astu. Wonderful. Next one, listen. Rudra Rupebhyah. Rudra Rupebhyah. Let's chant it together twice. Rudra Rupebhyah. Rudra Rupebhyah. Rudra Rupebhyah. The whole line, second line, let's listen to it. We'll chant it together later. Namaste Astu Rudra Rupebhyah. Namaste Astu Rudra Rupebhyah. Let's chant it together. Namaste Astu Rudra Rupebhyah. Namaste Astu Rudra Rupebhyah. Wonderful. Okay. Let's chant this verse together. Let's try it. Simply play along with me. Let's try it twice. Then we'll repeat this verse. That's all. This is the only verse we are learning today. Because it's difficult and powerful as well. I want you to learn it and meditate on the meaning of this. Sarve. Shall we start? Let's go ahead together. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Namaste Astu Rudra Rupebhyah. Once again. Sarve Bhyas Sarva Sharve Bhyo. Namaste Astu Rudra Rupebhyah. Let's chant this verse twice. Let's chant it 3 times and end the class. Listen to it once. I'll chant both these lines and then we'll do it together.
Aghore bhyo tha ghore bhyo ghor ghor tare bhyaha sarve bhya sarva sarve bhyo namaste astu rudra rupe bhyaha.
How beautiful is that? Let's chant it together.
अघो अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोरेभ्यो घोर घोरतरेभ्यः सर्वेभ्यः सर्व सर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्ररूपेभ्यः
अघोरेभ्योऽथ घोर घोरेभ्यो. Then you breathe in there and then say ghora ghora tarebhyaha. So watch my breathing.
Aghore bhyotha ghore bhyo ghora ghora tarebhyaha.
So just before go ghora ghora, just before that, take a deep breath. Because of bho and tha, you run out of breath here, right? So let's try that again. Take a deep breath.
अघोरे भ्योथ घोरे भ्यो घोर घोर तरेभ्यः.
One more time, breathe in.
अघोरे भ्योथ घोरे भ्यो घोर घोर तरेभ्यः.
Wonderful. Next one.
सर्वेभ्यः सर्व सर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्र रूपेभ्यः.
So before नमस्ते, again take in a deep breath. Let's try this twice. Breathe in.
सर्वेभ्यः सर्व सर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्र रूपेभ्यः.
Many of you can chant it in one breath and that's fine if you can comfortably do that. Once again, let's try it. Breathe in.
सर्वेभ्यः सर्व सर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्र रूपेभ्यः.
I salute this Rudra Rupa, this divine effulgent form of Rudra that comes in its terrifying nature, destroys all negativity around me. That is the power of this mantra. May this mantra energize us, empower us. And may it bless in removing all negativity in our lives. Let us end this class with one Om and three Shantis and continue in our journey towards Shivaratri.
Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.